It's your kawaii dad. Hello, friends. It's the Stitches, and we have another makeover show reaction. It's been a hot minute since I did one of these. One of the many recommendations that I've received from you guys is a show called 100% Hotter on Netflix. And I have been promised a better experience. From what you guys have told me about 100% Hotter, they do show a lot of alternative fashion, which I did notice to be true, and that they are much gentler with their guests than on, say, What Not to Wear. So this is my first ever experience with 100% Hotter. I haven't watched any of the other episodes. This was my very first one, and I had to choose one with a Lolita in it. So we're going to be reacting to season 3, episode 2, and I picked this one because in the description, it called the guest style doll-like, so I assumed that they were talking about Lolita, and I was right.
If your style is outrageous, outlandish, or over the top,
ooh,
fear not. 100% Hotter is here to make you under.
Yeah! Well, at least they have the decency to call them make-unders.
Tonight, a grown woman whose folly is to dress like a dolly.
I kind of want to be taken a bit more seriously.
I can already tell we're gonna hear lots of doll-like and dolly style and... Don't get me wrong, I think Living Dolls and the Living Doll community is actually really cool. It's very different from Lolita. Living Dolls can be Lolitas, but Lolita fashion is not inherently Living Doll. So that's our introduction to our Lolita guest on this episode. It looks like 100% Hotter pretty much always has like dual episodes, so you never have an episode that's just dedicated to one person. And the other person on this episode seems to have a self-tanner addiction, which is a shockingly common staple of these types of shows. However, I literally only care about the Lolita, so we're just gonna skip over him. I don't care. I don't care about his self-tanner addiction. Whatever. Gotta get that hair flip in there.
Should we see who's in the hot spot next?
Why not?
My girlfriend Kaylee can be best described as a colorful catastrophe.
Okay, first of all, if a man describes you as a catastrophe, leave him. Second of all, whose furry head is that? No shade, I'm genuinely curious.
Her style influence is like she's come out of a anime manga cartoon, and she's all pastels. She does have one black dress, but even that is still covered in stars and unicorns. Kaylee has so many different wigs, it's sometimes hard to recognize that.
Well, of course wigs are gonna look dumb when you don't wear them, right?
Kaylee is an amazing and stunning and beautiful person. I know she wants to be successful in her career, but I feel that her looks are holding her back.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, dear. We need to figure out first what she wants to do.
I wonder what she does.
Whatever it is, she wants to be taken seriously.
Yeah. If she works at a children's play fairground, we've got no hope for her.
I would argue that that's the perfect look for a children's fairground. I mean, it's not like you can't have two different wardrobes for two different purposes. If you want to dress alternatively, unfortunately, society is still society, and like, you need a small capsule wardrobe of basics that you can wear to places like job interviews. It's okay to dress differently for different occasions. I'm immediately jealous of her lavender shoes. That's a hard color to find.
Hi, Kaylee.
Hi.
Hi, Kaylee.
Hello, sweetheart. How are you feeling?
Nervous.
Don't be nervous.
You're in a safe place.
I'm not a huge fan of her makeup. I think the lipstick, while it perfectly matches her cord, kind of washes her out a little bit, especially the lower half of her face. It just makes her look pasty. It's a cute look for maybe Creepy Cute or Manhara, but maybe not for Sweet Lolita. But that's literally my only critique of this whole outfit. She just needs a warmer lipstick color. Other than that, I'm digging this look. I'm into it.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about your style?
It's kind of like based on Japanese Lolita. It's like Japanese fashion. I love it.
And how long have you been into this?
A couple of years ago, I started cosplaying, yeah. And I saw someone dressed like this at a convention and I thought, wow, I need to do that.
So why do you want it to end now?
I'm 28. I kind of want to be taken a bit more seriously than what I do.
And this is like an everyday thing? Like it's your staple, like go-to pastel-y look?
Yes, pastel colours are my thing.
Right.
Pastel-y.
Pastel-y look.
Okay.
What do you do for work, Kaylee?
I actually work from home. I'm too ill to work a normal job, so I sell makeup and vintage cosmetics online.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Do you mind telling us a little bit about what you mean by you're too ill to work?
I have systemic lupus. It's basically an autoimmune disease.
So how does that affect you day to day with work?
Some days I won't be feeling too bad, but other days I won't be able to get out of bed.
Okay. Oh, poor thing.
So you're lethargic and tired.
Yes, tired, achy.
I suppose. I suppose like dressing like this as well and being covered in colour probably makes you feel a little bit more upbeat.
Yeah, it does make things a lot better.
I've heard stories about lupus. Lupus kind of sucks. I can understand why that would make it difficult to like maintain a daily Lolita style. That's kind of the reason why I stopped being a daily Lolita. I got really into it in 2008 when I was like a teenager and in high school, and I wore like semi-daily casual Lolitas, sort of. But then I had to stop because I have like a digestive issue, and like layering on the tights, the bloomers, the petticoat, and then a skirt waistband, like all of that putting pressure like right in that one spot just So I ended up leaving Lolita initially in 2014, which is when I was in like probably the worst of my health issues. So I can understand why she might be looking to move on to something else. Lupus also on top of it causes like muscle aches and muscle weakness and all kinds of different problems. So okay, I'm not too mad that she's getting a make under. I just hope that they can at least maintain something feminine for her.
You mentioned that you work from home, but do you ever have to work with people face-to-face?
Yeah, we go to a lot of conventions where we have like training and talks and things.
Yeah. And do they take to your look? Or
they just don't take me seriously enough.
Kelly, we went and asked the public to share their thoughts on your look. Should we see what they have to say?
Yeah.
Oh god, there's a public interaction section. We're gonna interact with the public and ask, why do we care? These kind of segments never go well, but all right, let's see what the public has to say about Lolita fashion.
Ooh, is that her natural hair or a wig?
It's a bit loud. She looks a bit like she's wearing a lampshade.
A lampshade? Really? Really? People say the weirdest stuff about Lolita fashion.
The style, I would say, is quirky, but not necessarily in a positive way.
Quirky, but not in a positive way. You know when you're trying to not insult somebody and you just do it anyway?
I can see that she's actually given a lot of thought into how she dresses, but I don't actually think that it's worked.
I would rate her style about a 2 out of 10.
I rate her style 2 out of 10.
3 out of 10.
3 out of 10.
Okay, I have a hard time believing that they only went out and interviewed 4 people, because there were only 4 people in this segment. Did they really only interview 4 people and all of the people that they interviewed had overwhelmingly negative things to say? Really? Really? Are we really buying this?
Quirky. I like that.
How do you feel listening to those opinions?
I don't really take offense because I'm kind of used to people saying stuff like that, so I'm used to it.
I mean, you probably only showed a very select grouping of reactions, let's be real. But I'm also sure she's probably had worse said to her in person. I've had worse said to me in person. These actually weren't that bad. That portion actually wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. I thought it was going to be worse. We have not had a single person call Lolita fashion a costume yet. We're making good progress. We're 6 whole minutes in, and the word costume has not been uttered.
So, Kaylee, we got an average out of 10 from the members of the public. Do you want to find out what they rated you?
Yeah, go for it.
It was a 3.8 out of 10.
That's actually more than what I expected.
Hold up, hold up, hold up. A 3.8?
It just doesn't add up.
Well, look, why don't we get you on your way, then? If you'd like to get into this lovely work in progress t-shirt.
Wow, thanks.
And we will see you on the other side.
Okay, thank you.
Take care, my darling.
See you soon, darling.
Bye-bye.
Nothing like a big black t-shirt to make you feel like an individual and not like a conformist at all.
Dressing up is fine in your spare time, but Kaylee needs a style for work. one that still keeps her fun side for her down days.
The Hotter team are trend experts who can help the style blind to see the light.
Trend experts. But being trendy is not the same as being stylish. Being trendy just means that you have a lot of money to spend. Being stylish is something altogether different. And now we get a segment where she takes her makeup off and puts her hair down.
Cosplay Kaylee wants to ditch the dolly. And with her makeup masquerade now removed, Mel wants to find out more.
So original. Truly, this has never been seen or done before.
Hi, Kaylee.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm okay.
How do you feel without your makeup on?
I don't mind how I look without makeup, but you can see that I'm ill. You can see my dark circles, and I get, like, rashes on my face, and it causes this kind of thing.
I mean, I think you look really good without makeup. Well,
thank you.
I honestly think that she looks fine without makeup. Honestly, it wasn't doing her any favors. I think she mostly just needs some warmer tones, but like, she can still wear pastels, just warm toned pastels.
So the Harajuku style is obviously very colorful. It's almost like a physical way of looking positive, if that makes sense. So has that kind of helped build up your positive attitude as well?
Yeah, it does. Like, if I feel really, really crap on a day and I can't, like, get out of bed, I'll just bring my makeup box over and I'll sit and do my makeup in bed. I don't feel physically better, but I feel better in myself.
Yeah.
I don't look ill. I look bright and cheerful and happy.
It's a bit, like, therapeutic for you.
Yeah, I suppose it is a kind of therapy. Like, makeup makes me feel good and I use it as a way of expressing myself more than covering anything up.
So I feel like what we need to do as a team for you is to create a look that still gives off that positive energy that you do have, but just take it in more of a grown-up direction.
Yeah, because I think all the, like, pinks and purples and stuff are a bit young. I think I need to grow up a little bit.
Okay, to give 100% Hotter a compliment, I do enjoy that they at least portray the hosts as trying to get to know the guests and trying to get to know why it is that they wear the style that they wear and what their goals for their styles are. I will say that this is a very different experience from What Not to Wear. 100% Hotter is like driving by a little fender bender, like, you know that everybody's safe, nobody got hurt, there's minimal damage, this is gonna be fixed in a couple weeks and everybody's gonna move on with their lives. What Not to Wear was like watching a train derailment.
Colorful Kaylee craves a less extreme look and has come to Karen for some advice.
Hi. Hello, Kaylee. You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right, thanks.
You excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited to see what you've got for me.
All I'm going to do today is to just show you a few pieces that I think might open up your mind and just, you know, just get a real feel for what you kind of like and what you really don't like.
Okay.
Wait, are we getting, like, a real style segment right now? Like, she's actually showing her different garments and asking her opinions about them and allowing her to be an active participant in her makeover? That's something I'm not used to seeing in these shows.
Okay, so the first thing I want to talk to you about is the pussy bow blouse. What's lovely about this is the sheer fabric.
Okay.
I think it really makes this piece.
Yeah. I don't know, I don't like the black, but I like the style. I don't mind the spots either.
I think it's quite chic and quite grown up.
Yeah, I think so too. And I like the little bow. I like bows, so.
Okay, my next piece.
No.
The pencil skirt.
Okay.
No, just no.
This is very, very flattering for the female figure.
Yeah, definitely.
And I think if you want to be taken seriously as a boss babe.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to.
Yeah. I hate pencil skirts. I feel like they always want to put Lolitas in pencil skirts, but the fit and flare silhouette is right there. It's like, it's such a natural transition. Why? Why do we go straight to the pencil skirt? I don't understand.
I like the shape of it. I think it'd like bring my hips out a little bit, but not the red.
Let's forget the red, but the pencil skirt is very sexy.
Yeah.
It's quite a mature look.
Yeah.
You know, it gives you a little waist. You've got a lovely little pleat detail here.
Yeah, I do quite like it.
But just not the red.
No, not the red.
Yeah, I agree with her. That red on her pale skin is a mistake.
My third and final piece.
Oh.
Some jeans.
No.
Not lovely?
No, absolutely not.
What, because they're denim?
Yes, let's give the chronically ill person the most uncomfortable garment ever made.
The bottoms are awful.
What don't you like about the bottom?
And what do I like? They look like pom-poms or something.
Oh God, I didn't even see the leg fringe. What do I like, indeed?
No.
So you can't see those as an everyday piece in your wardrobe?
No, this is absolutely no.
But talk to me about jeans. Would you wear jeans?
I'd wear jeans if they had colour to them.
So you don't like blue jeans?
Not really, no. No blue, no black.
And no fussy bits at the bottom?
No fussy, sweepy bits at the bottom.
Okay, I'll make a note to myself then.
Okay, well, at least she's not being forced into anything that she doesn't like. 100% hotter so far is not the breath of fresh air that you guys promised me, but it is better than what not to wear. Leagues better.
So how are you feeling about the whole thing?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited about it. Nervous, but excited.
You're going to be in safe hands with Dan and Mel.
Yeah.
So why don't you go and see them now?
Okay.
And then I'm going to get to work on you a bit later.
Okay.
Yeah?
Thanks.
Brilliant.
Cakes on the makeup and hides her hair, so has come for a consultation on how to create a new look.
Hey, Kaylee.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm okay, thanks.
I'm a super casual guy, guys. I don't even, notice when my clients come into my shop. I'm so casual.
So what do you normally do to your hair, then? Or are you always a wig gal?
Not always a wig girl, but yeah, I like wigs because I like my hair long. I cut it because it started falling out. Sometimes I get bold patches and things.
It's not at the moment though, is it?
No, it's pretty good. It's all kind of grown in. I've got new hair growth here where it all kind of fell out at the front. When it starts falling out, is there anything I can do or?
I mean, it's falling out because of the illness.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a hard one to battle, really. I mean, taking internal hair supplements are always a good try.
Okay.
Anything that's going to nourish the hair from the scalp to the hair bulb outwards, just to keep the scalp and everything super nourished.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
That's unfortunate. I have a couple friends that have struggled with health-related hair loss, and it's pretty heartbreaking, honestly, especially when so many of us tied so much of our self-worth and our personal sense of beauty into our hair, and then to just have it all fall out because of reasons that are completely outside of your control is just... that sucks to go through.
I need to go and have a brainstorm, I think, so...
perfect timing.
Cue you. I'll see you guys later.
Okay,
see you then.
Later.
Okay, so let's talk makeup. Obviously, I know that you're very good at your own makeup. Are there any things that you struggle with yourself?
I do actually struggle with eyebrows.
Girl, don't we all, though?
You obviously know tools are really important.
Yes.
I would say go for, a really firm angle brush. And I've gone for, a colour that's quite ashy.
Yeah.
Because we don't want to go too warm, and then against your skin, it's going to look, orangey.
Yeah.
So what I'm doing is I'm starting with the product under the brow, and then I'm pushing it. Mm-hmm. Up, so I'm almost spreading it.
Oh, okay.
Kaylee was pastel perfect in her dolly outfit, but I wanted to put her in more grown-up colours and shapes.
She's not used to letting her hair do its own thing. I wanted to show her that she can use what she's got and wave that wig bye-bye.
Her makeup matched her Lolita look, but with some help with eyebrows and contouring, it's going to be no more little girl.
Kaylee!
Hi.
Ready?
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Nervous.
Excited?
Yes.
Ready to turn around?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Here we go. Yes. 3, 2, 1. Go for it.
Whoa, what the hell?
I actually really like it.
Okay, I don't even look like me.
How do you feel?
I love the hair. Yes, the hair is amazing and the makeup, oh my God, these eyelashes.
She kind of looks like a rom-com protagonist from 2007, and she just moved to the big city to make all of her dreams come true.
Do you want
to
take a look in the mirror closer?
Yeah, can I Oh my God, those eyelashes are amazing.
It helps that they didn't try to make her look too business casual. It's preppy, there's the suit elements, but there's almost a sort of grunge undercurrent. The pink bag is almost giving me Courtney Love on a business dinner. Okay, all right, we feel it. We see what you did there.
I mean, obviously you came in looking like the way you did in a lot of pastel, so we wanted to give you a little bit more of a professional look. So I feel like Karen's gone and given you a really playful sort of, like, yeah, take on that. You know, you've got the cute, like, platform shoe.
Yeah, I love the shoes, actually. I really like the shoes.
And a nice fishnet stocking.
Yeah.
And then I feel like it's a really playful, cute, like, version of a suit.
It's quite a big suit.
Yeah.
I love the skirt, actually. Like, good. I think if the jacket wasn't there...
Yeah.
It'd be, like, more... I don't know.
I think it's funny that she doesn't like the jacket because that's my favorite part. You can tell that she's not used to looking like that. And it's definitely jarring to see yourself in, like, a style that's super different from yours. But she also clearly doesn't hate it. She's not visibly uncomfortable like some of the people on the Jenny Jones show were. The warm tones do make her look really good.
I feel like you look like an 80s power woman.
I do, don't I?
Obviously, we discovered under that lilac wig that you had a lovely tone of green. I just wanted to give you a softer, more natural tone that was complimentary.
It's really nice.
How do you feel about that?
I really like the colour. I absolutely love the colour.
You know, I think it warms up your skin tone. It'll be super easy for you to maintain as well.
That's good.
And again, like, going forward professionally, I feel like, you know, you can still wear a wig if you want, but if you don't, then this is a really nice colour
like
and
this.
Style
yeah.
for you to wear, you know, on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah.
I loved her Lolita look, but, like, it's nice to see a makeover where the contestant is actually, like, smiling. A real smile, not like a I'm just forcing my face into the shape for the camera smile. Was this actually a decent episode for once?
We asked the public what they thought of your look before. Should we revisit what they have to say?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, wow, she looks amazing. That's so nice. Oh, my gosh.
Ah, she looks really nice.
No, she looks amazing.
She looks very pretty. She's definitely the girl that she walks in the street and you look at her because she looks very pretty. I like the eyes. She's got beautiful eyes, so it looks very nice.
I would rate this girl's style and her look as an 8 out of 10.
I would rate her look 8 out of 10.
I would rate her 9 out of 10.
I'd rate this look a 9 out of 10.
Why is she not getting perfect scores?
I like the whole, like, thing where they were saying with, like, the masculine, feminine look.
It is. It's a nice take on that.
Yeah.
Your previous score was a 3.7.
Okay.
And your new score is an 8.5.
Nice. That's a lot better.
It's a big improvement.
Yes.
Thank you, Kaylee. It's been such an inspiration having you here with us today.
Thank you.
I really hope you embrace your look and go enjoy it.
I will do.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Take care.
Bye.
So at the end of the episode, they give a little update on the guests, and she has kept that hair color. I'm actually really glad that's a really cute hair color on her. But she does still have a very Lolita-influenced look.
As for Kaylee, she's kept the hair color and toned down her clothes and makeup. She still plays dolly dress-up, but only at weekends.
She's wearing the same blouse that she had on earlier, but she's just styled it in a bit more of a mature way. You kind of get the sense that they gave her actual fashion advice behind the scenes. Although, to be honest, she wasn't bad at coordinating before. She just wasn't using particularly mature-looking pieces, which I think might have been purposeful in order to give her a more dramatic makeover. But I actually really enjoyed this episode. I didn't want to punch a wall or scream into a pillow at any point. No one called Lolita fashion a costume, which you don't think is asking for much, but it is. Clearly, the hosts at least knew it was a thing that exists out in the world. Like, they did more than 5 seconds of research on it. What? Shocking that a fashion expert would put more than 5 seconds of research into an alternative fashion. I came into this expecting to hate the hosts. I came into this expecting to hate the whole experience, and I was pleasantly surprised. I wasn't a huge fan of the street reactions. It just kind of felt forced and unnecessary, and also, like, why do we care about these people's opinions? But other than that, I was pleasantly surprised by this whole experience. 100% hotter gets an 8 out of 10. So yeah, that's all for today's video. I hope everybody has a good day. I hope everybody watches some good TV while in quarantine. And I will see you all next time. Bye!